I'm Remy Pengel with the Center for the Advancement of Sustainable Energy here at James Madison University. And today we're going to be thinking beyond the wind kit. So many of you have received one of our team kits to start preparing for a KidWind challenge. And in the kit, you have everything to build this turbine right here. So it is a very basic PVC structure with a generator, and you have your alligator clips and your multimeter so that you can measure the output. But when you start testing, hopefully you're going to start seeing that there's a lot of limitations to the system. And as an engineer, we want to move past the beginner kit here and think bigger and better. So we're going to go part by part through the turbine and talk a little bit about how we might re-engineer to make it better. There's three main parts to the wind turbine. So there's the tower, then there's the nacelle, and then there's the rotor, which is the blades connected to the hub. Let's start with the tower. I think this is the piece that gets overlooked most often by, hey, it's standing, so we're good, right? But honestly, if you start the fan and it starts pushing on those blades immediately, at least when I test it, that wind turbine starts to slide backward. The other thing that tends to happen is when the wind pushes on those blades, this will start to bend backwards, especially if you haven't glued all these joints together. They're a little flimsy. Again, remember that one of the big rules for the competition is that the wind turbine has to fit in the wind tunnel. But you're using like 18 inches here where you have like 3 feet that you can easily use and still fit in that wind tunnel. The big things that I would think about is how do you make the whole turbine and base heavier, wider, and sturdier. So PVC is great. I've seen people build them out of 2x4s and plywood. People have welded things. I've seen buckets of cement with one piece of PVC sticking up. That's very heavy and sturdy. That's not going anywhere. So just think about how you could make this tower sturdier. There's just a lot of things that could be re-engineered here. The next big piece is the nacelle. This one's a big one, okay? So right now your system is what we call a direct drive system. You have the rotor connected directly to the shaft of the generator, and then it's going to have a direct impact on how much electricity is generated. But we can create what we call the advanced nacelle. And if you've purchased a kit from Vernier, it may have come with one of these. And we have a whole nother video on how to put this thing together, so check that one out. But assuming that you have one already assembled, the easiest thing is we just pop it off of the PVC base. And now we can pop on our advanced nacelle. All right, and you'll notice that it looks like I put it on backwards. That's because the gearbox and the generator are going to be located in the back, and the blades are going to be attached to this drivetrain here. For the most part, you can use the same exact blade design, and if you add it to this gearbox here, you can see that it's generating a ton more electricity in just one rotation. This kit comes with a bunch of different gears, and I don't have it in front of you, but this gear ratio here, the little pinion set that goes onto the shaft of the generator is 8 teeth, and then the biggest gear in the kit is 64 teeth. So that's a 1-to-8 gear ratio. You can also play around with some of the smaller ones. You can create a 1-to-2, a 1-to-4 gear ratio. As you increase your gear ratio and how many teeth touch each other, you also increase the amount of friction that you're going to have in your system, and it makes it a little bit harder to start the system. You have to think about how your blades are going to overcome that friction, and we do that with increased torque, and we'll talk about that when we start talking about the blades. This is the basic kit from KidWind again. But think outside the box here too. KidWind is only going to give you enough gears to try the 1-to-2, 1-to-4, and 1-to-8 gear ratio. In the new nacelles, there's another hole here where you can stick a second shaft through to create a compound gearbox where you can add another gear set below. similar to this. So imagine this down here being your 1:8 gear ratio, but then the little shaft has a big gear attached to it that's doing another gear ratio. So it's compounded, and I don't actually know the gear ratio here. I'm assuming this is like a 1:8 and maybe like a 1:4. So in the end, that's a 1:32. So if we spin this once, this little one here should go around 32 times. And that's a compound gearbox. Now these are great and you can get a lot higher energy output, but again, with that high of a gear ratio, you're introducing a lot more friction to your system. You need to be really careful about how those teeth are paired and that you're pairing a set of blades that can overcome that friction using torque. You can also use your 3D printing skills to 3D print a much larger gear. Just remember, if you're 3D printing, make sure that you know where you got your files, how you created the structure, what the software was, all of those things, so that the judges will have that information when they ask. We've also seen a lot of pulley systems, and you're still getting that simple machine compounded energy output, but just through a different mechanism, pulley versus gear. And again, you don't have to use the KidWind Advanced Nacelle Kit. We have seen a lot of people just drill holes into the PVC itself to put their shafts in. You can build it out of wood or Legos or anything that you need. Grab your gears from anywhere you can find them and just have fun and try to get a lot of energy out of this nacelle. The other factor that we haven't even talked about in the nacelle is the generator. So as we know in the KidWind competition, this KidWind generator is the main kind of base division, the default division for KidWind. But, and this is the high torque generator that comes in some of the KidWind kits, and it does say high torque right on it. So be careful, because if you show up to the competition with this high torque, you're gonna be put into the open division and not the KidWind division. So you could use a high torque generator, which might give you a different output. But you could also build your own generator. This is another kit sold by KidWind through Vernier, called the Simple Gen. And the idea here is that you can use some insulated copper wire, wrap as many coils as you would like. This is a variable, how many coils you can get around the case. And then it comes with some strong magnets that go on the inside. And when you attach your blades, the magnet moves within the copper wires and it will generate electricity. There's lots of resources out there, and if you're looking for resources, feel free to contact me. I can do what I can to hook you up with that. But geared and direct drive turbines are all together in one division. As long as they're using the KidWind generator, it doesn't matter if you have a gearbox or not. Now that we've talked about the nacelle, we're gonna get into the rotor. When we talk about blades, there's a ton of variables. The first thing is, if you're using the 12-hole crimping hub that came with your kit, there's 12 holes. So you can put up to 12 blades in here. But because balance is a huge piece of a really good rotor, you will want to create blades that are multiples of 12. So you can have 2 blades, 3 blades, 4 blades, or 6 blades. Or you can do 12 blades, but 8 blades is gonna be off kilter. 5 blades is not gonna be really wonky. So you just wanna pay attention to balance and symmetry within your rotor. The other, of course, is the material that you build your blades out of. You're looking for materials that are sturdy, but light. We've talked about the chipboard. You've got your corrugated plastic, but another very good material to use is foam core. This is like your science fair boards, you know, foam poster board. Something that's sturdy like a 2x4, maybe a little too heavy, right? So you also wanna pay attention to the weight of your blades. And the weight not only comes in your material selection, but it also comes into the shape and size of your blade. So you've got, you know, a tiny blade that's small, pointed at the tip, or a really long blade that's rectangular. The other variable that you might not think about very often is how much of the dowel is showing. So when you connect it to your hub, do you have a big hole? here, or is it nice and close to your hub like this little blade here? It's a lot closer to the hub. So, you know, which one of those is going to make more energy? So we've got material, we've got shape, which includes length and width. So you're going to want to do a lot of experimentation. Balsa wood or basswood are also great kind of light and sturdy materials for making blades out of, especially if you want to be able to shape them maybe into an airfoil. The other variable to think about when you are working on your rotor is, but once you attach them, what angle are they going to be at? We call that the pitch. And in your kit, you were provided a pitch protractor. So the idea is this piece on the back that's molded is molded to fit right on the hub. And the idea is that you should be able to look straight down and figure out the angle at which your blade is at. And that way you can set all of your blades to be the same angle, but then also that you can do experiments on different angles to find out which angle is the best for your blades. That's a lot of flat blade talk, but again, you may want to try to make an airfoil. An airfoil is the shape that's similar to an airplane wing that's going to provide lift. In a wind turbine scenario, that lift is going to move it in a rotational direction as opposed to like lifting a plane up in the sky. So there's a lot of really interesting aspects to study in an airfoil. A lot of people will 3D print airfoils. Some will actually sand them and carve them out of balsa wood or basswood. I've seen a lot of people use laser cutters to laser cut like ribs that have that airfoil shape. There's also the white box learning simulator. You can model all of these things and create an airfoil that performs really well. And then you can actually export that to SolidWorks or a similar program and actually 3D print the blades that you modeled. So there's lots of really cool extensions for studying airfoils. The other piece that we haven't even talked about is the hub. So this piece here is something that comes in your kit. It does have its own limitations. Sometimes it doesn't crimp down enough on your dowel. If your dowels are all different sizes, your blades will fly out if you don't have the set pin set well. So we've seen people re-engineer this piece to create their own crimping hubs, maybe with a different number of holes in it so that they can make five blades work. Sometimes they'll even have set screws that they can screw in so that the dowel doesn't move. I've seen a lot of people trade out these wooden dowels for aluminum rods to reduce weight. And the last thing that I have noticed, which is really interesting, is if you're hot gluing your blades, that can be a huge weight issue. I've also seen this really interesting glue style where they actually go over top of it like stitches. So there's just a lot of different opportunities in the blades. So I hope these videos have been helpful. Between the tower, the nacelle, including gearbox and generator, and the rotor with the blades, you have a lot of opportunities to go beyond this wind kit.